What, the trigger's dead now?
At all. All right, let's see if there's something inside the gun.
Yeah. Oh, there it goes. Oh.
Nope.
I bet you. Well, hey, one. Oh. There it is. One out of.
Oh, you see that? What's that?
There you go. Uh-oh. What's that?
That piece is connected to the back piece right here.
Well, it's not connected, is it?
It's broke.
Dude, we put some JB Weld on it. It'll be fine.
Hey guys, Jordan Winkler here. Thank you for watching. In the last video I did on this Radical Firearms 7.5-inch AR pistol, I talked about how I was less than satisfied with the accuracy, even at relatively short distance at 60 or so yards, that I was getting from it. And so what I thought I'd do is throw this ginormous, don't you think it looks good on it? This Primary Arms 1-8 scope that I love, that's been sitting on one of my other ARs, my Anderson AR, and I thought I'd throw it on here, crank it up to 8 power, and do some sighting in of it at about 50 yards, and kind of see, especially when you have the advantage of a nice magnified optic like this, really kind of take myself out of it, for the most part anyway, still have to get a good trigger press and all that kind of thing, take myself out of it and see if I can get better, you know, better accuracy with the Radical Firearms AR pistol. So I'm going to be very careful not to shoulder this or really show it on camera whether I'm shouldering it or not. See what I did there? Okay, here we go. We just have to cover. Let's go see how we did. So here's the first shots through it. I was actually aiming here for the 3, so that's just gonna take some adjustment, but here's my 5 shot group down here by the 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So not really that great. I'm gonna go ahead and make some adjustments, do it again. So I didn't have the camera on, but I just took 3 more shots after adjusting this up 20 clicks on here, and it got about halfway to where I need to be, so I'm gonna adjust 20 more. Left to right seems to be okay so far. So let's see how we do here. If only I could shoulder this thing, it would make it so much easier. LOL. I think it's all right, let's go see how we did. Looks like we're pretty close to where we actually need to be. So first 5 shot group, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is my second group, 1, 2, 3. And right here was my third group, 1, 2, 3. So I might actually leave that alone, or I might just shoot some more right now and kind of see how we do. So if my math is correct, I've got about 9 or 10 rounds left here in this 20 round magazine. And I'm gonna shoot them all into the 4 and kind of see basically where I'm getting. I'm going to use the same exact hole. I'm not going to adjust for anything. I'm just going to pick a spot right there in the middle of the 4, shoot the balance of this magazine, and then we'll go up there and see how it's doing. Make sure everything's still tight on here. I mounted this on here this morning. Okay, still feels nice and solid. All right, here we go. That was the end of the magazine. Gun's functioning very reliably. It looked a little bit on the high side from back here. Let's go take a look. Interesting. Now this could be for a variety of reasons, I suppose. But now it looks like my overall group needs to come down a little bit. I was putting the tip of the chevron from that Primary Arms right here in the middle of the 4. And everything was a little bit on the high side. I had 3 in the dot. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it looks like it was 8 shots, and overall needs to come down a little bit left to right. Now I was getting nice, you know, trigger breaks, and this is the accuracy that I'm getting at this thing at 50 yards and with the 8 times optic. So not great in my opinion from the AR pistol, but I guess maybe my expectations are too high. I'm gonna try one more adjustment on this thing and then call it good. I'm gonna come back down since they're all a little high now. See how we do. Oh, I think I'm gonna pick a different dot too. I'll shoot dot number one. Try to get as precise as I can here. Okay, that felt good. Let's go take a look at the one, and then we're probably just gonna call it good here.
Well, here's the crazy thing. That was probably my best group so far. Totally in the wrong place. Way over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So quite frankly, I don't know what this pistol's doing. I'm using all the same ammo, been using minimum ammunitions all day. Again, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's after coming down 10 from this group that was high in the 4. To be honest with you, I'm not sure what to do with this thing.
All right, so while that last group was my best group so far, this gun is shooting all over the place. And even with a 8x optic, it's really a waste of this optic, in my opinion. So I'm not really quite sure what this gun's purpose is besides just being a range toy or being something really, really small for a really, really close-up type of work, which I don't really know that you need a 5.56 gun for that. But, like I said, I think this is a complete waste for this optic. So let's go ahead and get rid of this optic with this quick detach thing that is not too quick detach. Okay, the last thing I'm gonna do with this AR pistol before I probably just throw it in the safe for the rest of its lifetime, or get rid of it, flip it or whatever, is I'm gonna try to get these Magpul flip-up iron sights reasonably close so that if I ever actually had to use this thing, I mean, I'm glad with its reliability, that's great, but if I ever actually had to use it, it's reasonably reliable. So it's not very often that I feel like I have a firearm that's less reliable, that's less accurate than me, but I actually feel like this gun is less accurate than me, and I hope that doesn't make me sound like I have an inflated ego or anything. And those of you who have been following me for a couple years and seen me shoot, I think you know what I'm trying to say. All right, I've got the smaller aperture pulled up on here. I'm pretty sure dot number 2 is clean, so we're gonna shoot dot number 2 and see what we get. That's a lot more difficult after shooting that nice 8 power optic.
All right, pretty interesting stuff. This is actually my 3-shot group in the 2, which is, again, one of my better groups. Seems like the hotter this gun's getting, the better it's grouping. But again, aiming here, it was hitting over here, which interestingly enough is where it was doing it here a second ago. So I'm just gonna move this. If I can get that in here by just moving the point of impact right, that's what I'm gonna do.
Just gonna move this a little bit. And we'll see what we get. About 12 clicks or so. Someone was texting me or calling me during that, but it still felt like I get some good trigger presses, so let's go see how these iron sights did.
Well, dang, that's just about the best group I've gotten so far today. 1, 2, 3 with the iron sights. So what I might do is actually just come back just to touch. I moved, this was 12 clicks, so I'm just gonna come back like maybe 2 to shift a little bit more left, and then I'm just gonna leave it alone, and that's all I'm gonna do.
Here's the deal, like I just said, I'm gonna come back 2 clicks to the left on these irons, and that's really all I'm gonna do, guys. I'm not even gonna shoot it again. I'm probably just gonna leave this thing alone. The accuracy is confusing at best, and at worst, not very good. There is a piece of steel all the way down there at 100 yards, and I gotta see if I can hit it with these irons. Make sure I'm in the shot. Okay, here we go. Whoop. Malfunction. Oh, you gotta be kidding. All right, looks like it fed. Just didn't wanna let that one go. Now we're getting all kinds of, wow, really stuck in there. Let's see what's going on here. A bunch of light primer strikes. Almost like something else is wrong with the gun. Interesting. Let's check those rounds real quick, actually. Put this in here momentarily. See what we got. Well, one was not struck, and the other one looks like it has a strike on it, or that could just possibly be from chambering it. This gun might have just quit, guys. This might have just gotten a whole lot more interesting than just bad accuracy. I guess I should do this, huh? That might help. Alright, that was a hit. Alright. So, I can hit with the iron sights, of course with the smaller aperture, at 100 yards with this thing. I'm not sure what those last two kind of dud rounds were, but other than that, I think I'm done messing around with this thing for a while. For fun, I just loaded up those dud rounds again just to see what we get. Nice, at least I'm getting hits on the steel. All right, well, they went the second time. I'm not sure what that was. All right, go ahead, Kel. What, the trigger's dead now?
I mean, serious. It ain't alive.
Was he ejecting a live round or a spent?
Yeah, a live one.
It's cycling, it's just not, trigger's not reset.
Great. How was it literally working for me a second ago?
It's Calvin.
Sweet mother.
I told you.
Oh my.
Maybe it just doesn't like this ammo.
I don't
maybe
think so.
Like
it is a live round.
Yeah.
No, it is.
It's cycling fine. It's just the trigger's not resetting.
Don't look at me, man.
Damn it.
I would separate and see if you got a...
No, we just tried it without...
No, I'm talking about you might have a primer in the lower or something causing...
That was a little low. I saw that one.
That was okay. A little low. Let's...
I'm going to check my groups. Damn.
Wait, Kelvin, just show for the camera that the trigger's...
Working?
Not resetting. No, without any bullets or magazines, just...
Well, how am I supposed
just
to...
dry. Just dry.
Oh,
show that the trigger's not resetting.
Wow.
And nothing.
Right. Oh shit, it didn't reset that time.
It's not doing anything now, is it?
Oh.
I was tripping.
It's not working at all. Alright, let's see if there's something inside the gun.
Yeah. Oh, there it goes.
Oh.
Nope.
I bet you there's a primer.
Well, hey, there it is. One out of...
There's a primer in the lower. I'll lay money.
Okay.
Turn it upside down and do a little bangy bangy.
No, I think I broke it.
Okay, well that's even better. Yeah, something don't sound right.
Something moved in there.
Hey, you guys want a good deal on a Radical Firearms 7.5-inch AR pistol?
I'm pretty sure there's supposed to be a piece right there. You see that?
$150 out the door.
Well, yeah, I'll do that. Look, I'm pretty sure that spring's supposed to be covered. Oh, you see that? What is that?
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, we know where we're not getting
right there.
To fix that.
See?
There
uh-oh.
You go.
What's that?
That piece is connected to the back piece right here.
Well, it's not connected, is it?
It's broke.
Dude, we put some JB Weld on it.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the thing that keeps that spring in there.
Okay. There you go.
Because the spring sits in there and this U-piece kind of humps right there that's attached to it.
Kind of humps it.
Connector. Yeah. Dude, that wasn't me.
So it's broken.
Yeah, it's broken. Yeah, this piece is supposed to be.
You got a hold of it.
See? It's broken off right there.
Yeah.
Looks like a shitty cast piece or some shit.
Man, it would have broke eventually. Like probably when you were trying to defend your life or something.
Oh, maybe you don't need it. I mean, it is technically only there, I think, to keep that spring there.
Hey. Look.
No, it's to put tension on this. It has to put upward tension on it. You can't do it if that piece is broken. You need to replace that piece.
It's broken. I just need to call him up.
Is this a factory? Everything?
Yeah.